I just knew what I had tried, I liked. And so it had created almost a craving now within me.
Ever since middle school, California girl Kim Zember had felt different than other girls. Growing up in a loving Catholic home with two older brothers, she preferred sports to makeup. Then in high school, she heard a rumor that a friend of hers was gay, which brought other feelings to the surface.
I started for the first time thinking maybe I was gay. I was drawn to this girl, and yet I knew that what God said. The scriptures were clear that, you know, acting on homosexual desires was not in his will, and so it was a wrestle for me, but it didn't stop the feelings I had.
So one night at a party her senior year, Kim kissed her friend. Turns out the girl wasn't gay and ended the friendship. For Kim, however,
I just knew what I had tried, I liked, and so it had created almost a craving now within me, and I felt like I, from that moment on, saw women differently.
So after high school, on her own and building a successful career in real estate, Kim started having secret relationships with women, even while dating men and going to church.
I really was craving someone to be intimate with, that would love me, care for me, and that I could love and care for too. So I lived a double life for years.
Confused and ashamed, Kim turned to a Christian counselor for help.
I was told that that's kind of who I am, that I shouldn't fight it and that God loves me.
Then at 21, Kim started dating a Christian man who inspired her to live out her faith.
It didn't take away my desires for women, but I did love who he was. I saw Christ in him. I could see Jesus literally within this man, and I loved him.
Kim says it was then God led her to move to Ethiopia with her boyfriend, where she taught English and started a nonprofit.
It was in Ethiopia that my heart started opening, that I started seeing past myself and into other people. I didn't really have a desire for women. When I was walking in purpose, on purpose, and for a purpose, there was very few distractions.
That changed very quickly after they returned to the States and her boyfriend proposed.
I was absolutely terrified. I knew that I was using this man. I knew that I was staying with him to not be alone. I loved who he was, but I was not in love. I didn't know what to do because I didn't know what my life would look like without him.
In 2009, they married, but Kim still struggled with her attraction to women. A year later, she had an affair.
I had promised God the night I got married that I would never cheat on him with a woman. I made a promise to God, but I didn't ask God for help. And I broke that promise because it's one I couldn't make and I couldn't fulfill on my own.
Kim admitted to her affair and they divorced. She also went back to counseling.
The advice that I got was, this is who you are, live it, God loves you. And I heard so much about how much God loves me. I thought, well, why am I not loving myself? And so I embraced the lifestyle.
No longer in the closet, Kim spent the next few years bouncing from girlfriend to girlfriend, afraid to be alone, and still searching for intimacy and peace.
Everybody told me that once I would openly date women and stop hiding and stop cheating, that I would finally find freedom, and I didn't. I think it honestly was worse for me, because now I was living a lifestyle openly that I knew was not right. In the depths of my being, I knew.
Then in the fall of 2014, Kim discovered her girlfriend had cheated on her. That pain was the wake-up call she needed.
I realized not only was I hurting myself, I was hurting so many people, my family, the people I was dating, my ex-husband, and I was done. I knew that God did not create me to go around hurting people like this. And so the only option I had in my heart and my mind was to surrender. And I said, I'm done, God. I surrender, I give up. And I want you to be God. I want you to be Lord over my life, Lord over my desires, Lord over everything I got, because I can't do this anymore.
Kim invited God to help her deal with her struggles, not just in that moment, but daily.
I started to encounter him in this real, tangible way that I never knew. I knew a lot about him, but I didn't know him personally. And when I asked him to be Lord of my life on my own, I started to experience him. I felt this intimacy that I was craving in the physical or in the deepest part of me was now actually being fulfilled in a way I never heard about. And so it was absolutely life-changing for me.
Kim continues running her ministry in Africa and is now what she never thought possible, a happy single woman who has found true companionship in Christ.
Jesus Christ himself was tempted and never fell. And so for me, I'm not looking for a life free of temptation. I'm just thankful that I have a Savior that is greater than any temptation I face. And that's why he wants me to journey with him every day, because I don't know what temptations are ahead of me. God created happiness. He created fullness, and he created us to live in that. But we cannot find it without him. We cannot find it separated from him in any way.
Yeah. I believe God wants me to share something with you guys, and he put this on my heart. He will not reject you if you come to him. He won't. He loves you so much. If you just come to him with open arms and say, God, just like Kim did, she got to the end of herself, the end of her rope, and she just said, God, please be Lord of my life, Lord over my desires, Lord over everything. And if you do that, friend, if you do that, he will not reject you. He's not going to turn his face against you when you come to him. If anything, he's running towards you with open arms and saying, my child, yes, this is what I've been waiting on, for you to come home, for you to come to me, because I've got a place for you, a special place for you. Come, do things my way. Let me wash you clean. Let me help you in whatever present situation you're in, whatever you're struggling with, let me help you and let me love you. That is what God is saying to you today. And if you want to pray that prayer, just like Kim did, making Jesus the Lord of your life, do it right now. Pray with me right now. Jesus, I cry out to you and I say that I need you in my life. I need you, Lord, to be Lord of my life, Lord over my desires, because I can't do it without you. So God, I believe in your son, Jesus. I believe that you died on the cross, and I believe that you resurrected 3 days later. Come into my heart, forgive me of my sins. Be Lord over everything. I love you, Jesus. From this day forward, I dedicate my life to you. And I say thank you for what you're doing in me. Thank you for what you're working through me, God. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. And if you prayed that prayer with me, please give us a call at 1-800-700-7000. The best is yet to come for you. Hey everyone, I'm Ashley Key. Thank you so much for watching this video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so we can reach more people with encouraging content like you just watched, and so you never miss a beat. See you next time, and God bless.